So the ocean to me was always a really special place. I think many folks expect researchers or marine biologists who study the ocean to have grown up near there, but I actually think it's because I didn't that I'm so fascinated by it. But it truly is a really underexplored frontier. The ocean is particularly hard to study because we can't breathe underwater, right? And there are so many limitations to our abilities to observe what's going on. Hi, my name is Alex McInturf. I am a PhD candidate at UC Davis, and I study shark behavior. There's over 500 species of shark worldwide, and they come in all different shapes and sizes. They have different reproductive strategies. They occupy different places of the world. They have different body shapes. They eat different things. There are so many things about sharks that are diverse. When I went to the beach, we used to take these trips to Florida when I was young. And I just distinctly remember looking out at the water and frankly feeling a little bit intimidated by everything that was out there that I couldn't see. So I loved being in the water. I was never afraid of going in. But there were just moments when I would look out at like this vast expanse of ocean and be just a little bit in awe. And I think that was the moment where I was like, can I study the ocean for a career? And my dad said, yeah, I think that's called marine biology or something. I have had really wonderful moments and worked in like the most beautiful of conditions where the water is clear, the sharks are everywhere. You go underwater for hours at a time and you're just with them. And that is, those are the best days, of course. But for every best day, you have like a week of bad days where you either can't be out in the field because the conditions aren't good enough, or you have entire field seasons where your sharks don't show up. You have days where you're terribly seasick out on the water because the conditions are bad. So those are all components that I think people think marine biology, you know, you're out in a bikini on a boat in the sun and it's great. And in reality, a lot of it now is, you know, you get out for a few days a year, you put some transmitters on sharks that you can then download the data for later, and then you leave and you are on your computer the rest of the year. Sharks are a little bit difficult to study, right? Especially some of the sharks that I work with, which can be endangered or threatened. And so what I have started to do is try to broaden the questions I'm asking with sharks to different systems and different organisms. And so we're sitting in a lab because I'm currently working on examining how temperature affects the likelihood of fish being eaten. It's the balance of being in the lab for a project and then going to the field to do in-field research actually really complementary, because I can be in a lab and manipulate the environment that these animals are in and see how they respond, right? But it's really hard, I think, sometimes if you only do lab work to then project and see how this all might play out in a realistic natural setting. I can manipulate things in the lab, I can control for these external factors that might actually be affecting their behavior in the wild, but then I get to go to the field. And when I'm in the field, I get to sort of understand, oh, these other factors that I've controlled for in the lab might actually be really important. And so I will spend probably 3 to 6 months of the year in the lab working on an experiment, trying to understand how temperature is affecting the fish that I'm studying. And then I'll spend a month or two in the field studying how sharks might be moving around and measuring in-field temperature, for example. Obviously, when I'm in the lab, it's a little bit difficult to feel as connected to the ocean as I would like to be. So I'm based in Davis, which is about 2 hours from the nearest coastline, maybe a little bit less. And so on weekends that I have free, I'll try to get out there and either go scuba diving or free diving, which is diving without any of that scuba gear, or I'll snorkel, or I'll just try to get to the beach. And that's something that I've really tried to prioritize, because I find that, you know, if my passion is driven by the ocean, it's really important for me to continue to be motivated as a scientist to get that sort of spark by going out there. And there's certainly ups and downs to being a scientist, and it can be really challenging at times, but at the end of the day, every day I get to say I'm doing science is pretty incredible.
Hi guys, thanks so much for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe, and definitely check out some of our other videos either here on the YouTube or on Instagram or on SciAll.org. We look forward to chatting science with you. next time.